Welcome to Hanging with Hyde's Daily Devotional. This devotional is dedicated to my two sons, Jerry and Seth. For a hard copy of today's devotional, which includes all scriptural references that support my statements in today's post, please go to my website, HeidiJoLopez.com, and look under the tab, Daily Devotional. Day 52. Good morning. This morning, I was awakened early with a beautiful word from the Lord for me. So I got up and wrote it down because I didn't want to lose it. I prayed and asked him if there was more, and I asked him if he had me up to pray as well. Not knowing for sure, I prayed in tongues for a bit, and then I thanked him. I thanked him for all he has provided, for every amazing answer that he has already answered, but I do not see it yet. I thanked him for what he is doing in the United States of America, even though I haven't seen it all played out before my eyes. But I know it is complete in his spirit. After we had our time together, I went back to bed. As I went to bed, I still asked him to speak to me. I often ask him to speak to me and to open my ears so I don't miss it. I fell back to sleep for several hours. As I was waking up in that place of asleep and awake, he began to speak to me and show me amazing things regarding his incomparable love for us. I awakened at the realization of his conversation with me, and I was asking him to solidify it in me so I would be able to get it down and share it with all of you. And as I sat down to write this morning, I had a thought. What is God saying to you? Are you writing it down? Have you asked him what you are supposed to do with what he has been sharing with you? Because nothing he shares with us is ever just for us. Now, there are times he speaks to us on personal things, maybe correction, emotional and spiritual healing. Yet even in those things, we should be ready to share with others at his prompting. Then there are those things he shares that you're thinking, why are you sharing this with me? I don't have a big platform to proclaim it from, and yet you know it is a life-changing aspect for the whole body of Christ. For me, that's usually when I hear, be faithful in the little things. And that's how my show, Hanging with Hyde, really began. Our youngest son, Seth, spoke it out probably more than 20 years ago, not realizing he was speaking something prophetically. He didn't know God had given it to him to say, but when he heard it, he instantly repeated it. When I heard it from my husband, when he repeated it to me, Holy Spirit opened my spiritual ears. I recognized a God call in it, and I tucked it away in my heart. Over all those years, I held it, once in a while taking it out and pondering it. God gave me ideas about it, a vision to carry it through to completion. And last year, he told me to launch it. And like maybe many of you, I blinked at him and said, but who am I supposed to do these shows for? I only have 3 or 4 followers on my YouTube channel. And even at that, they don't really follow me because I don't post anything. I just kept hearing, start hanging with Hyde. I knew it was a be faithful in the little things moment. So I have been, in the past, a huge perfectionist, wanting everything to look right, sound right, the right equipment, etc. So I ordered a few things, tried to make the show as professional as possible, which wasn't very, and the show just went thud. I could tell when I was recording it, so I never posted those recordings. Then I heard God say, not audibly, but very clearly and a bit firmly by this point, do it now and do it raw. Why raw? Because although the show has my name in it, it is absolutely not about me. It is all about him. And I needed to get over my quote, end quote, caring what people thought of me in regard to it, what my hair looked like, I looked like, or sounded like. All of those things were frivolous and fleshy, and I needed to lay them down. I had to once again die to self. So I pushed record, prayed, and said whatever Holy Spirit told me to say. And that's how all of this began. It has been just over a year, and now I am doing a daily devotional, well, at least a 5 days a week devotional, and God is speaking to me more now than he ever did or maybe more accurately, I am hearing him more clearly than I ever have before. Why is that, you may ask? Because when we are faithful in the little things, he gives us much more. Now, I don't have a huge platform that I can see 10 times more than I started with on YouTube, though, but I preach and teach as if I am speaking to the whole body of Christ and the unsaved, because in my heart, I am. I keep everyone inside me as I teach and preach, just as when I'm writing a novel. I always have my audience in mind. So I know how to get the thoughts or the storyline across. It is the same way in raising our children. We must always have a view of them as adults in our mind's eye and then ask God, how do I get them there, Lord? What is my daily part of that picture? Now, I know the thousands and millions of people God has for me to share all of these things with are out there. And the beauty of recording is that no matter how he brings them in, the teaching is always there for them to grab onto and grow with. What am I teaching through the daily devotionals is really a foundational class, discipleship. And no matter the time, it is all living and breathing and still what we all need. A recording is much like a book, which can be written and sitting there waiting to be read and gleaned from. All the truths in it, if God-given and full of biblical revelation, are living and breathing, just waiting for someone to pick it up, open it, and read it. Like the Bible, the greatest gift next to Holy Spirit we could have, both right there before us, ready to give us every truth that is in existence, but we have to choose to open the book and read it. We have to choose to open ourselves up to Holy Spirit and invite him in as our gift to understand the Bible, hear fresh revelation, to know our boundaries to keep us safe, and to help us fulfill the destiny placed in us at conception. So, what am I the most excited about regarding to be faithful in the little things and I will give you much more? The greatest, most amazing thing is the incredible relationship I have with God himself. Every day I press in, I ask questions, and I expect answers. How can I do that? Because he promises in Scripture to answer us when we call to him. Call to me, and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. Jeremiah 33:3. I am waiting expectantly on him all the time because I am constantly asking him new things, asking him to speak to me, asking him to reveal more of himself to me. I ask to know Father God more intimately. I ask to know Jesus God more intimately and to know Holy Spirit God more intimately. Yes, they are one, but they are also individual as well. It takes faith to wrap our brains around that amazing concept. But if we begin to look at everything in creation, we can see the triune Godhead everywhere. So when we, by faith, believe God is one and three, we have seeded that into the earth. And as we hold fast to that amazing truth, God will open our eyes to see three in one all around us. And when he begins to reveal the intricacy of three in one, it will literally catapult us closer to him. How do I know? Because it has been that way for me. And Jeremiah 33:3 is our promise scripture. Call to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. So let me ask again, what is God saying to you? What is he revealing to you? Are you writing it down? Are you searching scripture with him to have him blow your mind with the truth of the fresh revelation? Because if he gives you something, he will always take you to his word to search it out. He does nothing apart from his word. As you search it out, are you consecrating to that new revelation so that the enemy of your soul, Satan, cannot come and steal it away, as it talks about in Mark 4? Are you then asking Holy Spirit, what do I do with it? Whom do I share it with? And if you have asked him that and he gives you a name or an avenue in which to share it, Be obedient to step out in any way he asks you to do, because faith is an action. Until we activate it through obedience in whatever way God is asking us to step out in it, it is dead. How do I know? For as the body without a spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also. James 2:26. I am leaving you with this to think on for today. Tomorrow we will continue on with this same topic, because Holy Spirit has a lot to say regarding it. I speak blessing over you, that your spiritual ears will be completely opened, so that you will hear all the revelation God is speaking to you, and you will write it down, consecrate to it, and begin to ask him how to share it. Be encouraged, for his grace is always sufficient. Walk in that grace in your life and freely extend it to those around you.